शहनावतु सहनौनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं यदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुमहदेवात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशमुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपञ्चं शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशानमुमय्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धिर्तर्कितुं पारं सर्वेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्ब्रह्म तदेवाहं कंटिन्यू विद द उपासना विश्वः विराट अकार मात्रा इत्येतेषां अभेद चिंतनम्. सो विश्व विराट एंड अकार दीज आर ऑल वन बिकॉज ऑफ व्हाट प्रथम बीइंग आदिमत्वात् डू यू सी दैट विश्व विराट अकार चिंतित विश्वस्य सप्तम. या आई थिंक वी सॉ दिस राइट 300 वी सॉ दिस विश्व विराट अकार मात्रा. We saw this yesterday. Anyway, just let me read it. I'm not sure whether. So, Virajha Vishwasya cha yatha abhedha tatha omkara prathamatrayaha akarasya virad rupa vishvena saha abheda asti. Have you seen this? Tatha hi brahmana chatursho padeshu prathama padha virat atmana chatursho padeshu prathama padha vishvaha. So, on the samashti and vashti side, prathama padha is virat and vishva respectively. There is abheda between them and ओंकारस प्रथम पाद इज अकार प्रथम मात्रा दैट इज एज दो पाद ओंकारस्य मात्रात्मकेषु चतुर्षु पादेषु प्रथम पाद अकार त्रयाणामेषां आदित्व रूप धर्म सामान्य सत्वात् बिकॉज आदित्वम इज कॉमन बीइंग फर्स्ट देयरफॉर विश्व विराट एंड अकार आर ऑल वन विश्व विराट अकाराणाम अभेदम चिंतयेत. दिस इज हाउ चिंतन हैज टू बी डन इवन इफ वन डज नॉट अंडरस्टैंड इट. It can be dhyana. Ittham vishvasya saptangani saptangani ekone vimshati mukhani cha vyakhyatani. Sorry. So this is how these are to be understood as narrated, as explained, and then one can do dhyana as well. Now vishva and taijasa. In the closing, I just mentioned how the prakriya is. Vishva will be collapsed into Tejasa, Tejasa into Prajna, and Prajna into Turiya Atma. At Turiya level, there is no second to think of even to collapse. There is nothing at the Samashti level. Vyashti and Samashti are one. In fact, they are one in Shushupti itself. One cannot make out a difference even in Shushupti. Raja and, Raja and the beggar, Bhikshuka, both are one. Simha and Mashaka are one. There is no Bheda in Shushupti itself. But still, Ajnana continues. Ajnana going away, Ajnana lacking, Shushupti Ajnana, is the Turiya Avastha. Compared to the other three, it is called the fourth, but it is not really the, really a separate Avastha. It is that which pervades the other three and completes them. That is the Turiya, which is common, which is, it is not common, it is one without a second. In other cases, we can talk about commonality and then think of Abheda. But at the Turiya, there is no Abheda Chintana possible because there is no Bheda at all. There is no Upadhi Bheda also. Vishwatayasyor Bhedaha. First of all, what is the difference? And then you collapse them. Vishwatayasyor Bhedaha. Vishwasya. उक्तानि सप्तांगानि एकोनविंशति मुखानि च तैजसस्यापि सन्ति इति अवगन्तव्यम्. द सेम 19 अंगास विच आर देयर इन द विश्व दे आर देयर इन द सूक्ष्म शरीराभिमानि तैजस आल्सो. किंतु यान अस्ति भेदः हाउएवर देयर इज सम डिफरेंस. व्हाट इज दैट? विश्वस्य अंगानि मुखानि च ईश्वर सृष्टानि तैजसस्य तु इंद्रिय देवता विषय रूप त्रिपुट्यः शिराद्यंगानि च मनोमयानि. The difference is that the Jagatkarta is not Jiva, it is Ishvara. Whereas the तैजसा जगत इज स्वप्न प्रपंच, दैट स्वप्न प्रपंच कर्ता इज हु इज दी अंतकरण ऑफ तत्त स्वप्न द्रष्टा जीव. सो जीव इज दी क्रिएटर बिकॉज हिज अंतकरण इज वॉट क्रिएट्स दी स्वप्न प्रपंच मनोमय. एंड मय हियर इज विकारार्थे, सो इट इज मनस विकार स्वप्न प्रपंच. ऑल ऑफ दीज इंद्रिय देवता विषय रूप त्रिपुट, ऑल दीज त्रिपुटीज दैट वी सॉ, ऑल दोज आर शिरादि अंगानी च मनोमयानी. द शिरादि अंगानी मीनिंग ऑल दी सप्तो दी एकोनविंशति मुखानी, दी 19 मुखास आर आल्सो क्रिएटेड बाय दी मन ऑफ दी तैजस ड्रीमर. तैजसस्य भोगा सूक्ष्मः एंड दी विश्वस्य भोगा वा स्थूलः, स्थूल प्रपंच. भोग नाम सुख दुखाद्यनुभवः. सो भोग जनरली पीपल से भोग इज एंजॉयमेंट, इट इज नॉट एंजॉयमेंट, इट इज जस्ट एन एक्सपीरियंस. इट कैन बी ईदर, इट कैन बी सुख ऑल्सो दुख ऑल्सो एंड समथिंग न्यूट्रल ऑल्सो. सो आदि यद्यपि अनुभव रूपे ज्ञाने स्थूलत्व सूक्ष्मत्व भेदो न संभवति, तथापि बाह्य शब्दादि विषय संघात साक्षात् जायमान सुख दुखादि साक्षात्कार स्थूलः इत्युच्यते. Although the anubhava is not at the stula level, anubhava is always at the sukshma level. Even it is so subtle, it is not as gross as the antakkaran also, because the anubhavi becomes one with the anubhuta and the anubhava also. The triad is resolved really. During the anubhava, any anubhava, during the anubhava, there is merger of the subject and the object becomes one really. That is the reason I say that I am happy. Why is not the antakkarana sukhavritti cognized easily? Why is it that I say I am happy and I don't say that I cognize happiness? Because the difference is so lost on me, it is as though I have become one with the sukha itself. Therefore, aham sukhi ityadi vyavaharah. Yadyapi anubhava rupe jnane stulatva sukshmatva bhedah na sambhavati. Jnana here is, the anubhava is jnana. Smriti bhinna jnanam anubhava. So this is also jnana, anubhava. Whether it is stula or sukshma, the anubhava is same. Therefore, stulatva sukshmatva bhedah na sambhavati yadyapi. Tathapi still. Why is it called as stula bhoga? Why is Vishwa called as stula bhuk? Because bahya shabdadi vishaya sanghat sakshat jayamana. Indriyas are in play. The difference is the indriyas are connected to the bahya vishaya in the case of stula anubhava. In the case of sukshma anubhava, indriyas are not connected. Even if we say indriyas are connected, they are imagined, kalpita indriyas in the swapna. Those indriyas are not the same as the indriyas in the jagrat avastha. Therefore, bahya shabdadi vishaya sanghat sakshat jayamana sukha dukkhadi sakshatkara stulah ityuchyate. That is the difference. मानस शब्दादि संबंध जायमान सुख दुखादि साक्षात्कार सूक्ष्म इत्युच्यते. वेर एज दी अनुभव वेर देर इज नो इंद्रिय संबंध, देर इज ओनली मन संबंध, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज सूक्ष्म अनुभव. तथा च श्रुति ही एंड देर इज सच श्रुति स्थूल भुग वैश्वानर प्रविभक्त भुग तैजस इति. So there are these definitions also as stula bhuk. Stulan padarthan bhungte iti stula bhuk. And pravibhaktan. Pravibhaktan are different. Different from what? Different from stula. That is sukshma. Therefore, pravibhaktan bhungte iti pravibhakta bhuk taijasaha. Vishwo hi stula bhung nityam taijasaha प्रविवक्त भुक् इति च तैजसस्य भोगयोग्याः शब्दादयः मानसत्वात् सूक्ष्माः. एंड देयर इज अनदर श्रुति विच सेज विश्वः इज स्थूल भुक् नित्यम ऑलवेज स्थूल भुक् नेवर डज दी विश्व हैव एनी सूक्ष्मानुभव. सूक्ष्मानुभव बिलोंग्स टू दी तैजस प्रयुक्त भुक् इति च तैजसस्य भोगयोग्याः शब्दादयः. दी शब्द रूप रस गंध इत्यादि दीज आर ऑल व्हाट तैजसस्य भोगयोग्याः पदार्थः. एंड दीज आर व्हाट्स सूक्ष्म. व्हाई मानसत्वात् बिकॉज बीइंग दी प्रोडक्ट ऑफ मनस इमेजिन बाय मनसा कल्पितत्वात् सूक्ष्मः. तदेपेक्षया विश्वस्य भोगयोग्यः शब्दादयः बाह्यत्वात् स्थूलः. सो वाय स्थूल बाह्यत्वात् विश्वास यू नो भोगयोग्यः पदार्थ दोज विच आर फिट टू बी कंज्यूम्ड बाय विश्व द वेकर आर स्थूल बिकॉज ऑफ बाह्यत्व. एंड बाह्यत्व मीन्स कंसिडरिंग द बाउंड्री ऑफ द शरीर नाउ स्थूल शरीर. किंच विश्व बहिष्प्रज्ञः तैजसः तु अंतःप्रज्ञः. Here it will be pronounced as bahishprajnah, but in Mandukya, Chandasa Prayoga is bahishprajnah. So, no, this is actually, it will be bahishprajnah, the visarga preceded by pakara, and fakara has a different pronunciation, but here it will be bahishprajnah. In Mandukya also, this sandhi is like this, bahishprajnah. So, kincha vishvaha bahishprajnah, taijasaha tu antahprajnah. So Vishwa knows the world outside and Tejasa knows the world inside. We know these differences. Yataha Vishwasya antakkarana vritti rupa prajna bahirgacchati Tejasasya prajnana bahirgacchati. Very easy. So the prajna does not go out. So vritti does not take place outside. It takes within in the case of Tejasa's anubhava. Tasmat tau kramena bahishprajnatvena antahprajnatvena cha vyapadishyete. That is why they are called as, you know, differentiated by calling them as Bahishprajna and Antahprajna. Taijasa Hiranyagarbha Ukara. So now we have seen the Bheda. Now Taijasa Hiranyagarbha Ukara Iti Etesham Abheda Chintanam. We have seen this in the case of Vishwa, Virat and Akara. So the same process is going to be repeated. So I'll just go through it. There's not much to be done there. So let's look at the tippana first. Sakshi Chaitanyam Chittasya Ashira. We have seen this. Anugraham Kartasya Chitta. Yeah, we have seen this. Taijasa Hiranyagarbha Ukara Ityetisham Abheda. Abheda Chintanam, how do you do that? So Taijasa is second. Hiranyagarbha is second. Ukara is second. Or Taijasa is subtle. Hiranyagarbha is subtle. Ukara, very difficult to see subtlety there. But at least between Hiranyagarbha and Taijasa, we can see Sukshmatvat, Sukshma Sharira Abhimanitvat, Abhedaha, and Ukara is the second, just like Taijasa and Hiranyagarbha. Yatha Vishwavirajoho Abhedaha, Tatha Taijasa Hiranyagarbha Yor Abhedo Jnyeha. So, Dhyana as well as Chintana both can be done. Taijasa Se Upadhi Sukshmaha, Hiranyagarbha Se Upadhi Rapi Sukshmaha. There is a subtle Upadhi for both. But Hiranyagarbha is at the samashti level and Taijasa's upadhi is at the vyashti level. Tasmat tayor aikyam bodhyam. Therefore, sukshmatvat, sukshma sharira abhimanitvat, abheda taijasa hiranyagarbha yor ekatvam nishchitya omkarasya dvitiya matraya ukarana sah tayor abhedam chintayet. Then they are also second pada at the pratyagatma's, you know, Atma when you're looking at, or you're looking at Ishvara also, Brahma. There are four padas and the second pada happens to be Taijasa at the Vyashti level and Hiranyagarbha at the Samashti level. Omkara's second pada or Matra is Ukara. Therefore, there is Abheda among all these three. Atmanas Chaturshu Padeshu Dvitiya Padas Taijasa, Brahmano Dvitiya Pada Hiranyagarbha, ओंकार मात्रा सुद्वितीया मात्रा उकारा द्वितीयत्वं त्रयाणामेषां समान धर्मः तस्मात् त्रयाणामैक्यं चिन्तयेत्. सो बिकॉज ऑफ बीइंग सेकंड वन कैन लुक एट द इक्वेशन फॉलिंग इन प्लेस. प्राज्ञः ईश्वरः मकारः इत्येतेषाम् अभेदचिन्तनं. सिमिलर्लि एट् दि थर्ड् पाद आल्सो वन् केन् डू दिस् सेम् चिन्तनं. प्राज्ञम् ईश्वरौ रूपं जानीयात्. वन् शुड् नो प्राज्ञ एस् वाट् ईश्वररूप. वै? बिकास् आफ् बीङ्ग् दि थर्ड् पाद एस् आल्सो दि अभिमानि इन् दि सुषुप्ति अवस्था एट् दि व्यष्टि अण्ड् समष्टि लेवल्. ईश्वरः प्राज्ञश्च सोरि ईश्वरस्य प्राज्ञस्य कारणशरीरम् उपाधि. सो कारणशरीर उपाधित्वात् देर् इस् कारणशरीर अभिमानित्वात् व्यष्टिसमष्टियो समष्टिमध्ये अभेदः चिन्तयेत्. ईश्वरस्यापि कारणम् एव उपाधि. सो वेदर् यु काल् इट् एस् अविद्या उपाधि प्राज्ञः एण्ड् माया उपाधि ईश्वर, माया एण्ड् अविद्या हेव् नो डिफ्रेन्स्. वी हेव् सीन् अर्लियर् ईश्वरः प्राज्ञश्च पादेषु तृतीयौ. We also know that they are Tritiya Pada at the Brahma Samashti level and at the Atma Vyashti level. Omkarasya Tritiya Matra Makara. Therefore, all three are one. This is how Chintana Dhyana can be done. Trishu Eteshu Tritiyatvasya Samana Dharmatva Tesham Aikyam Chintayet Soyam Prajnaha Prajnana Ghano Bhavati. So Shruti says Prajnana Ghanaha. One homogeneous consciousness. That is the लक्षण ऑफ प्राज्ञ. यू कैनॉट डिवाइड दिस प्रज्ञा एट ऑल. यू कैनॉट सी सेगमेंटेशन बिटवीन इंडिविजुअल्स ऑल्सो, विद इन द इंडिविजुअल ऑल्सो, एंड बिटवीन एन इंडिविजुअल एंड यूनिवर्सल ऑल्सो. यू कैनॉट सी एनी डिफरेंस. प्रज्ञान घन एज दो सिंगल यूनिट ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस, सिंगल होल, इट इज वन विदाउट अ सेकेंड. दैट काइंड ऑफ प्रज्ञान घनत्व इज देयर इन सुषुप्ति अवस्था. यस्मात् जागरस्वप्नयोर् यावन्ति ज्ञानानि स्थितानि तानि सर्वाणि सुषुप्तौ घनीभवन्ति. सो व्हाट इज दिस प्रज्ञान घनत्वम्? दि ज्ञान विच इज देयर इन दि जागृत अवस्था. व्हाट इज दैट ज्ञान? अबाउट दि प्रपंच, जागृत प्रपंच. दैट हैज बीन कोलैप्स्ड, मर्ज्ड इनटू अ सटल फॉर्म, इनटू दि बेली ऑफ दि तैजस. इट हैज बीन कोलैप्स्ड इनटू तैजस. तैजस कंज्यूम्स दीज. Not consumes is as in anubhava, but consumes is in becoming the adhisthana to merge in the dhyana process. Similarly, the sukshma prapancha anubhava is there for taijasa. So jnana is variegated. Just like there is variety of jnana in jagrat avastha, variety of vishayas also. Similarly, Taijasa also has variety of anubhava, variety of vishayas to consume, to have bhoga of sukshma bhuk. So sthula bhuk and sukshma bhuk, there is sukshma jnana and sthula jnana in respective avasthas. These jnanas are not ghana. They are so many, but all of them become one in the sushupti, where all of this is merged. So in the prajna, everything is merged. Therefore, prajnasthana is where there is prajnana ghanatvam. The jnana ghanatvam is there. That is the reason it becomes a karana for the other two. Satkaryavada. All the jnana which is there in the jagrat and swapna, it is there in a subtle form, in a bija rupa, in the shushupti avastha. That is the karana sharira there. Karana for what? For stula and sukshma shariras, prapanchas also. Therefore, the jnana which takes place in stula and sukshma avastha, in jagrat and sapna avastha, all those are one, which cannot be differentiated in sushupti. Tasmat prajnaha prajnana ghana ityuchyate. Why? Because tani sarvani sushuptau ghani bhavanti. Which are ghani bhavanti? This is chi pratyaya. Chi pratyanta, usage, and chi is what? What wasn't there is there now. Acha tadbhave. So aghanam ghanam bhavati iti ghani bhavanti. What was not ghana in what? Jagra swapna yoho. Yad aghanam tad ghanam bhavati. If there are, you know, multiple, because they are plural. Ghani bhavanti. That is why prajnana ghanatvam is there in Sushupti avastha. Avidya mata rupatam bhajanti iti avata. What is the idea of ghani bhavanti? What do you mean by prajnana ghana? Ghanatvam. Prajnana ghanatvam. There is avidya mata rupatvam. So avidya mata rupatam bhajanti iti avata. That is the idea. Tasmat prajna prajnana ghana ityuche uchyate. Ayam prajnaha anandabhuk iti shruyate. What is the bhojana of prajna? It is ananda, because swarupa ananda vyatirikta, nothing else is there. Anandabhuk prajnaha yato ayam prajnaha avidyavrutam anandam bhunte tataha anandabhuk iti vyapadishyate. He has swarupa ananda bhoga, but it is covered up by avidya. Therefore, during the consumption, during the Shushupti avastha, he doesn't know that I am Anandabhuk then, but he recollects on waking up. Vishvatayasyo riva prajnasya api bhoge triputi varnyate. So there is triputi even in that avastha, it can be talked about, although one cannot make out the difference. Chaitanya pratibimba sahita avidya vrittihi adhyatmam ajnanavruta swarupanandha adibhutam ishwaradi devam iti. So adideva, the adishthatru devata, is Ishwara himself in Shushupti avastha. Chaitanya pratibimba sahita is pratibimbita. So chaitanya pratibimbita avidyavrutti is adhyatma, and ajnanavruta swarupanandha. This is the adibhuta there in Shushupti avastha. This is the triputi. Itham vishvaha bhaish prajnaha taijasa antah prajnaha prajnaha prajnana ghanascha bhavati. Anayaritya vishvaha bhaish prajnaha taijasa antah prajnaha prajnaha prajnana ghanascha bhavati. So same thing is repeated there at the vyashti and samashti level really. Vishvadinam trayanam ekatvam turiyasya ishvara sakshina abhedam cha chintaye. Now you land on the fourth. Vishwa, Taijasa and Prajna at the Vyashti level. Trayanam Ekatvam. All these three are one. Vishwa may not know Taijasa. Taijasa may not know Vishwa. During the avastha, the waker and dreamer don't know each other. The deep sleeper also does not know the other two. So each does not know the other two. Vishwadinam trayanam ekatvam, but they are all one. As the turiya, they are all one. Turiyasya ishwarasya sakshina abhedam cha chintayet. And then once you land on the turiya, see, the chintana need not be at the samashti level. It can be, but need not be. I need not think that Virat is Hiranyagarbha is Ishwara, because they are all collapsed in the Vyashti in this chintana. Virat is collapsed in Vishwa. Collapse is this oneness there, Abheda. There is no difference between Virat and Vishwa. There is no difference between Hiranyagarbha and Taijasa. There is no difference between Ishwara and Prajna. Now, when I am doing chintana, I am merging Vishwa into, resolving Vishwa into Taijasa, Taijasa into Prajna. Who happened to be me? All of these three are me. They are not different from me. I know Vishwa, I know Taijasa, I know Prajna. They are all me. That is the reason I have Pratyabhijna of the Vishwa, continuing as Vishwa the next day. I recall the dream as Taijasa. And I know that I slept well without experiencing anything gross or subtle as Prajna. I am the same in all the three states. So Vishwa, Taijasa merge into Prajna, and Prajna into me, who I am really not limited to any of these three, but I am pervading all three. Itham Vishwadinam Trayanam Mitho Bheda Upadhi Prayukta Eva. Each one has various avastha upadhi, various sharira upadhi. Therefore, त्रयाणां भेद अस्ति म्यूचुअली मितो भेद उपाधि प्रयुक्त एव इफ यू टेक अवे द उपाधि देर कैन नॉट बी एनी म्यूचुअल भेद आल्सो विश्वस्य स्थूलं सूक्ष्मं अज्ञानं च इति त्रयम् अपि उपाधि व्हाट इज द उपाधि फॉर विश्व विश्व हैज स्थूल उपाधि बट सूक्ष्म इज देयर विदाउट द सूक्ष्म देर कैन नॉट बी अ स्थूल रैपिंग सो देयर इज अ स्थूल रैप ऑन द सूक्ष्म Abhimana, then there is on top of that, there is Stula Abhimana. This Stula Abhimana is so strong that Sukshma is not easily recognized. But it is there. And Sukshma can be there only when Ajnana is there. Sukshma cannot become an Upadhi otherwise. Sukshma Upadhi continues to be there across Stula Shariras, whether in waking state or across Janmas. So these three, Stula, Sukshma and Ajnana, which is basically what? Stula, Sukshma and Karana Sharira. These three, all three are the Upadhi for Vishwa. Tejasasya Sukshma Ajnanam Chaiti, Dvayam Upadhi. Stula Abhimana isn't there for Tejasa, therefore he has only two Upadhis. Prajnasya Ajnanam Ekam Eva Upadhi. And then in the Shushupti Avastha, there is only one Upadhi, which is Ajnana. There is no Stula or Sukshma Upadhi. Therefore, Prajna has only Ajnana as Upadhi. Ittham Upadhi naam adhikya nyunatvabhyam trayanam bhede api vastuta swarupena na bhedaha. Swarupa bheda isn't there, Upadhi krita bheda is there by additional Upadhi. Prajna who has Ajnana as Upadhi takes another Upadhi becomes Tejasa by taking Sukshma Upadhi and then by taking the Stula Upadhi, both Prajna and who has now become Tejasa, becomes Vishwa. This is how Upadhi Krita Bheda is there. If you take away the Upadhi, Swarupata Bheda Nasti. Vishwa Tejasa Prajneshu Trishu Anugatam Chaitanyam Paramarthata Upadhi Traya Asambandham Avatishtate. The Chaitanya which is there in all the three is my real Swarupa. So upadhi tray asambandham. There is no connection of Chaitanya with any of these. Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya continues as Shuddha Chaitanya in all the three avastha. Trayanam upadhi nam adhishthanam turiyam. This is the turiya means fourth, but fourth in comparison to the third, it's just to differentiate between the three, but not separate really. By number, it is only a separation by reference point being the other three. So we have numbers in the other three, therefore there is a fourth, which makes the three complete. That is the fourth. Tadhi na bahish prajnyam, nantav prajnyam, na prajnyanaghanam. So Mandukya Upanishad defines it as not bahish prajnyaha, not antav prajnyaha, not prajnyanaghana, na karmendriyanam, jnanendriyanam va. Vishayaha. So this Bahish Prajnaha, Antav Prajnaha and Prajnanaghana, these are respectively the Vishwa, Tejasa and Prajna. The Turiya is none of these three and is not a Karmendriya, Jnanendriya Vishaya, na Buddher Vishaya, na Kasyapi Shabdasya Vishaya, Etadrisham Turiyam, Paramatmanaha, Chaturtha, Padatmaka, Ishvara, Sakshi Rupa Shuddha Brahma Swarupam Janiya. So that Turiya Pratyagatma, which I am, who takes on Upadhis and becomes other three, who is not a Karmendriya Jnanendriya Vishaya, not Buddhi Vishaya, not any of these, Kasyapi Shabdasya Vishayana Bhavati, who is beyond the Vak and everything else, every other cognition, objectification, etadrisham turiyam, that kind of turiya who is not the fourth outside, he is me pervading the other three, that me is non-different from Paramatma. Paramatmanah chaturtha padatmaka Ishvara sakshi rupa. So Ishvara sakshi is the jiva sakshi turiya me. That is the Atma and Brahma Abheda, who is Shuddha Brahma Swarupam. It is Shuddha Brahma Swarupam Janiyat. One should know that. There is a Tippana there. So some explanation is given with an example. So yatha tandula kana jalena pindi kruta eki bhavanti yatha va grushtyudaka bindavaha nimna desham prapya tadagadi rupena eki bhavanti tatha jagrat swapna kalina nana jnanani shushupta avidyayam eki bhavanti. So just like, you know, how the rice becomes, you know, when you cook it with water and then make a lump, you cannot see the differences in the kana of the rice. Or, you know, vrishti udaka bindavaha, the rain, when it is the rain, when it's falling, you can see the bindu, you can see the drops, you know, you can see droplets and then drops, but then once they fall on the ground, they become one. Similarly, is this abheda when you do the dhyana, this is how the chintana karma is. Tatha jagra swapna kalina nana jnanani. And in the prajnana ghanatvam, what is that prajnana ghanatvam? There is this tippana. Prajnana ghana, where jnana becomes one. Just like droplets become one, or the cooked rice can be made a lump. Similarly, the jnana in the, which is nana vidhani, nana jnanani in the jagrat and swapna become one in shushupti. Where in the ajnana of the shushupti become one, means they were one, they have been manifested, now they are drawn back again. Tadrusha avidya pratibimbita chaitanya rupaha prajna jivaha adhishthana kutastha sahita prajnana ghana ityuchyate. One who has this ajnana, where the jnana has become one, ghana, he is called as, this prajna jiva is called as prajnana ghana, who is adhisthana kutastha sahita, chaitanya rupa, of course, and tadrusha avidya pratibimbita chaitanya rupa. Chaitanya rupa, but reflected in the avidya, and this is the real definition of jiva also. Jiva is not antakkarana pratibimbita chaitanya. Jiva, we have seen, is avidya pratibimbita chaitanya. And because antakkarana is manifest from ajnana, therefore the reflection also continues there. And that is an upachara we have seen long back when we saw the definitions of jiva ityadi. Dvisvarupasya atmanah dvisvarupena omkarena abhedam atma padanam omkara matranam cha abhedam chintayet. So now the chintana is at the level of turiya. Ittham paramartha rupam aparamartha rupam iti atmanah dvidam swarupam uktam. So there is paramatma rupa and aparamartha rupa. You've seen there. Tatra trayah padaha aparamartha swarupam. Turiya padaha paramartha swarupam. In reality, I am Shuddha Chaitanya. But when I take upadis, then I become Vishwa Tayasa Rajna. At the Samashti level also, Shuddha Brahma with association, with Maya association becomes Ishvara. And then with Sukshma association becomes Hiranyagarbha. And then with Stula association becomes Virat. They are all aparamartha sarupa. Paramartha sarupa is Shuddha Chaitanya, or less Turiya. Turiya pada paramartha sarupam. All the other padas are aparamartha sarupa. Atmana iva omkarasya api sarupa dvayamasti. So although there is sarupa de atma and visvarupena omkarena abhedam. Omkara also is seen with these bhedas, because there is matra traya. Matra trayamasti, and there is amatra also. That is a disvarupa. And disvarupa atma, what is the disvarupa of atma? Vishwa tayasa prajna, where nana jnanas are there, or there is avidya continuing in the shushupti avastha. So in the subtle avastha, there is prajnana ghana at least. So prajna is there. Whether ghanattvam is there or aghanattvam is there, in all the three cases, prajna is there, which is the manifest form, objectifiable. Whereas the other swarupa, of Atma is Turiya, which is Shuddha Chaitanya. So at all levels in the sense, in all the three, rather, you look at the Vyashti and Samashti, and then also Omkara. Omkara also has Vishwarupa because of Matra and Amatra. Atmana iva omkarasyapi rupadvayamasti omkara, sorry, akara okara, akara ukara. So akara ukaram hakarat atmaka matra tray rupa aksharas. So akara ukara makara atmaka. So akara ukara makara atmaka matra tray rupani aksharani aparamartha surupam, whereas matra tray vyapakam, which is amatra, that is the paramartha surupam. Astibhati priya rupam adhishthana chaitanyam paramartha swarupam. And Omkara is what really? Omkara is the name for Ishvara. So if you look at the Akara, Ukara, Makara and Amatra Veda, the first three have Matra, the fourth does not have any Matra, so it is silence. And Ishvara's, it's Ishvara's name, Brahma's name, Saguna and Nirguna, this is the Swarupadvaya of Brahma also. So Matra Traya Vyapakam Asti Bhati Priya Rupam. Asti is Sat, Bhati is Chit, and Priya is Ananda. So Satchid Ananda Rupam Adhishthana Chaitanyam Paramartha Swarupam. Omkarasya Paramartha Swarupam Shrutau Amatraha Iti Shabdena Vyapadishyate Amatra Chaturto Vyavharyaha Iti. So in the Mandukya Upanishad it is Amatraha Chaturta Pada, but Amatraha. First three are Akara, Ukara, Makara, then Amatra. Once the mouth is closed, there is no sound, that is the silence. Avyavaharyaha, there is no Vyavahara possible with this Amatra. Yataha tasmin paramartha swarupe matranam vibhago nasti tasmat tad amatram ityuchyate. Because there is no matra, bheda, vibhaga. Therefore, this Omkara, Omkara's fourth pada is called as Amatra. Ittham swarupadvayavataha omkarasya swarupadvayavata atmana saha avedam janiyat. So the omkara in total and the atma in total. Atma has four padas, omkara has four padas. Atma's four padas can be divided as the vishvatayasa prajna as one set and turiya as the second. The first set is Aparamartha Rupa and the second is Paramartha Rupa, Shuddha Chaitanya. On the Omkara side also, Akara, Ukara, Makara have Matra Bhedas and Amatra has no Matra at all. So there are two Swarupas. The earlier three are Aparamartha Rupa, whereas the Amatra Swarupa is its real Paramartha Rupa. Thereby, the earlier three we have seen Abheda. At the Vyashti Samashti level also, and Akara, Ukara, Makara also, we have seen individually being one with the Aparamartha Rupa triad. One on one. Now, at the Turiya level, Amatra level, Brahma level, there is no difference at all because all three are Shuddha Chaitanya. There are no three also. There is no possibility of using the number also. There is only one Shuddha Chaitanya called with different names. There is no Upadhi Veda also. So at the Paramartha Rupa, there is no difference at all. At Aparamartha Rupa, we have done Chintana of how they have Abheda. So in totality, if you take the Paramartha plus Aparamartha Rupa of Omkara, of Samashti and Vyashti, there is no Bheda at all. Therefore, in toto, all three are one. There is no Bheda ever. So it is ever among anything, there is no kind of Bheda possible. The five Bhedas that we have seen, all the five Bhedas go away and there is only Ekameva Dvitiya Brahma Tadahamasmi. This is how we understand Abheda इन ग्रैनुलरिटी ऑल्सो स्टेप वाइज व्यष्टि समष्टि स्थूल प्रपंच सहितयोः विश्व विराजोः अकारेण अभेदं जानीयात् आत्मनः पादेषु विश्व प्रथम ओंकारस्य मात्रासु अकारः प्रथम मात्र अतः तयोर ऐक्यं विद्यात्. सो नाउ स्टेप्स आर रिपीटेड टू सम अप. यू लुक एट द फर्स्ट पाद ऑफ विश्व अकार एंड समष्टि एंड व्यष्टि ऑल्सो स्थूल प्रपंच सहितयोः. विश्व एंड विराट आर विद द स्थूल प्रपंच. They have that as their own sharira. Akara is one with them because of being gross. Atmas, pada, first pada, and the samashti, Brahma's first pada, is gross. Therefore, there is oneness, and also because they are one, it is one with Akara's Akara matra of Omkara. सूक्ष्म प्रपंच सहित हिरण्य गर्भात्मक तेजसम उकार रूपेण जानीयात. सो नाउ यू हैव सीन दी सूक्ष्म प्रपंच अभिमानी व्यष्टि एंड समष्टि एंड आर एज वन बीइंग सेकंड दे आर आल्सो वन विद उकार. आत्मनः पादेषु तेजसो द्वितीय ओंकारस्य मात्रासु उकारो द्वितीय मात्रा तस्मात् तयोरैक्यं विद्यात्. यू हैव सीन दिस इट्स जस्ट अ समरी. कारण उपाधि सहित ईश्वर रूपं प्राज्ञं मकार रूपेण विद्यात्. One should also consider the Karana as one at all three, at the Vyashti Samashti level and then the Makara in the Tritiya Matra, because all three are the third. Tatastayor Abhedam Janiyat Atmanas Trishwapi Padeshu Anugatam Paramartha Rupam Turiyam Omkarasya Trishwapi Matrasu Anugatat Omkarasya Paramartha Swarupat Amatrat Abhinnataya Janiyat. Then the Turiya, this cannot be segmented at the Vyashti Samashti level, can be collapsed into the Turiya Amatra Swarupa of Omkara. So Vishwadishu Turiya Anugataha Tatha Akaradishu Tisrishu Matrasu Amatraha Anugataha. So we know the Amatra is there, which pervades in the other three. In Omkara also, Akara, Ukara, Makara, and in Vishwa, Vishwadishu, Vishwa Taijasa and Prajna also, this Turiya continues to exist. So there is an Anuvritti of Turiya all the way in all the three Padas also, and Amatra also has Anuvritti in all the others. Because without us, without something being there, you cannot have a have any utterance also. So there has, on silence there is an utterance. So this is some chintana you can do. It is not one word on the other, but it is one letter on the other, but it is akara on the amatra. There is matra on the amatra. So amatra has anuvritti. This is how one can see the anuvritti of amatra in all the akara, ukara, makara. अनया रीत्या आत्मपादानां त्रयाणां ओंकार मात्राणां तिसृणां च एकता चिंतन रूपं लय चिंतनं कुर्यात्. दिस इज हाउ द चिंतन ऑफ ऐक्य एट द व्यष्टि समष्टि एंड ओंकार लेवल. जस्ट टू से ओंकार लेवल मीन्स ओंकार इज एक्चुअली समष्टि लेवल इटसेल्फ, बट देन सीन एज शब्द. सो शब्द स्वरूप ऑफ इज of samashti is in Omkara, and through Omkara as a tool we can do laya chintana. So this ekata chintana will lead to laya chintana, and laya chintana will lead to aikya jnana or aikya dhyana. Laya chintana anuvadaha. So now there's a anuvada. So it's just a repetition of laya chintana. एक एक मात्रा रूप विश्वादीनाम अन्य मात्रा रूपतः. लय चिंतनम इदानीं निरूप्यते. सो दिस हाउ डज ऑल दिस रिजोल्यूशन टेक प्लेस. दिस इज जस्ट द चिंतन ऑफ ऐक्य. नाउ लय, हाउ डज लय टेक प्लेस. विश्वात्मक अकार तैजसात्मका उकारात न भिन्न. दिस इज द लय. वी हैव सीन एट इंडिविजुअल and total level differences, but once you resolve the Vishwa into Taijasa, Vishwa is Akara, that at that level we have seen the abheda. Now this akara, which is vishvatmaka in the form of vishva, that is not different from tejasatmaka ukara. So akara is not different from ukara. This is the laya chintana. Vishva is not different from tejasa. Vishva, who is akara, is not different from tejasa, who is ukara. Kintu ukara rupa eva. So you collapse the akara into ukara. What is this akara now? Akara is vishva. He is collapsed into ukara. Which ukara? This ukara, which is tejasa. Evam chintanam eva layaha iti uchyate. Evam eva itarasu api matrasu uyam. So similarly, we follow this process in other matras also. Yasmin ukare akarasya layaha krutaha tam tejasatmakam ukaram prajnyatmakam akare leenam kuryat. So you resolve this makara, which is tejasa, in whom akara, which is vishwa, has been resolved. That makara, which is tejasatmaka, you resolve into ukara, which is tejasatmaka, you resolve into makara, which is prajna. Prajna rupa. Prajna rupam makaram api turiya rupe omkarasya paramartha swarupe amatre leenam kuryat. Then the makara, which has ukara and akara in its belly, which is non-different from prajna, who has tejas and vishwa in its belly, seed form, belly meaning in the seed form, should be resolved into turiya. This turiya has no difference at all from amatra, and there is no vyashti samashti bheda at all. And who is this vishwa? Vishwa has the stula prapancha with the stula prapancha abhimani virat also as one. because there is abheda at the vyashti samashti level, and when you think of vishwa, you should think of virat and stula prapancha also as being one in vishwa. When you think of tejasa, where you resolve the vishwa, tejasa is one with Hiranyagarbha along with the sukshma prapancha, and prajna is one with Ishvara, into whom this tejasa is resolved. That kind of a prajna, who is non-different from makara, should be resolved into amatra of omkara. Yataha stulasya utpatti sukshmad bhavati, stulasya layascha sukshme bhavati, tasmad vishwarupa akara tejas rupe ukara liyate. Liyeta. So just like this stula utpatti is from sukshma, stula's laya is also in sukshma. Similarly, vishwa rupa. Therefore, vishwa rupa akara is resolved into tejas rupa ukara. Sukshmasya utpattihi karanad bhavati, sukshmasya layascha karane bhavati. And sukshma has utpatti from karana, sukshma's laya is also in karana. Therefore, tejasa tasmat tejas rupa ukara tatkarane prajna rupe makare liyeta. Atra vishwadi grahanena swasvat triputya saha samashti virad samashti should be virad dvayopi. It must be dvaya, I think. So samashti virad or adaya, it should be adaya. So samashti virad adaya api grihita bhavanti. So atra vishwadi grahanena, so I have explained this. Just if you take the vyashti, who is actually the sadhaka? Samashti is not the sadhaka, vyashti is the sadhaka. So every chintana is from the vyashti's perspective, where the samashti is collapsed. So vishwadi grahanena swasva triputya saha, along with the triputis at the individual level, the samashti triputis are also, you know, also collapsed, also understood to be one. Yasmin prajna rupe makare ukarasya laya krutaha tam makaram turiya rupe omkarasya paramartha rupe amatra leenam kuryat. Omkara paramartha swarupasya turiyasya cha abhedo asti. So same thing is continuing at the various levels. So I'll just read it. Tachcha turiyam brahmeva. This brahma is called as turiya. There is no abheda to be talked there, because only when bheda is there is an equation to solve. Turiya is fourth in comparison to the other three, but there is no separate vyashti samashti upadhi bheda also. Therefore, tachaturiyam brahmeva tasmin shuddhe brahmani ishvara prajna kalpitau. In that one single brahma without a second, the vyashti and samashtis are imagined. So prajna and ishvara are imagined on the shuddha chaitanya brahma. Yad yasmin kalpitam tat tat swarupam iti nyayaha. And we have seen in the Rajju Sarpa case also, Sarpa is adhyasta on Rajju, kalpita on Rajju. So, yaha sarpaha yasyam Rajjau kalpitaha sa sarpaha Rajju swarupam eva. Similarly, yad yasmin kalpitam tat tat swarupam iti nyayaha. Tena nyayena, Ishvara is also Brahma Rupa, Brahma Swarupa, Prajna is also Brahma Swarupa. Tasmad Ishvara Saita Prajna Rupa, Tasmad Ishvara Saita Prajna Rupam Akarasya Amatre Layaha. I should be Omkara, I think. Tasmad Ishvara Saita Prajna Rupam. Rupa, okay, Rupa Makarasya, okay. Tasmad Ishvara Saita Prajna Rupa Makarasya Amatre Layaha Yujyataiva. So this Ishvara, who is not different from Prajna now, that Prajna who is resolved into Makara, Makarasya Amatre Layaha Yujyataiva. So all of these, Tasmad Ishvara Saita Prajna Rupa Makarasya is Makara, which is Prajna, which is Ishvara, that Makara is resolved into Amatra, and that resolution is valid. It is not invalid, it is not tangential to reality, it is in keeping with reality, therefore it is tenable. Yujyate eva itham yasmin omkarasya paramartha swarupe amatre sarvesham pravilayaha krutaha sa eva aham asmi iti aikagrena anavratam chintayet. So taila dharavat, this chinta should continue till no more chinta is possible, no more chinta is needed, and it is not possible also, because once it is resolved, you cannot have the mind ticking anymore, it will stay in this tattva. Nikhila charachara prapanchatmaka asanga advaya asamsari nitya mukta nirbhaya brahmarupaha yah omkaraha tasya yat paramartha swarupam tadeva hamasmi iti adarena nairantaryena cha dirghakalam yaschintayati tasya jnanam udeti. So jnanam udeti, shravana being there, when one continues to do this chintana, nikhila charachara, the complete chara achara prapancha, is all superimposed on that same Brahma. So nikhila charachara prapanchatmaka asanga, the same asanga Brahma, which without any sangha, even during srishti, sthiti and laya, appearing as charachara prapancha completely, nikhila, remains asanga. That asanga and never becomes dual, let alone plural, that kind of a advaya asamsari atma, who is nitya mukta. Nirbhaya. Dvitiya advai bhayam bhavati. There is no dvitiya, there is no bhaya. So that nirbhaya brahma rupa yaha omkaraha, that pranava omkara, tasya yat paramartha swarupa. Paramartha swarupa is amatra. Tadeva aham asmi. Shuddha chaitanya is me. Iti adarena. Shruti, shabdas, and Shruti is explaining this laya chintana, one should have adara towards it, and then nairantaryena cha. You cannot, you know, put droplets of oil. It should, taila dhara is a continuous flow. Similar should be the chintana and dhyana. So dhirga kalam, it is not, you know, I have done it, I don't need to do any more. How long should one do anything? Asana, pranayama, any of these. One should do it till one does not have to do it anymore. It should become automatic. It should become your second nature. Your first nature in the antakarana should become second nature. Advitiyattvam is our first nature, which is our real nature. First nature means real nature. Nobody uses first nature. We say second nature. Second means our second nature is, you know, going towards the Baisha Vishayas, considering ourselves as individuals. So all these, considering ourselves as individuals, which is our second nature, should be dropped, and second nature should be our real nature. So there is no second nature at all. We should hold on to our real nature, which is Shuddha Chaitanya Swarupa, which is Ekamevadvityam. So Dhirga Kalam Yas Chintayati Tasya Jnanam Udayati. Because of this Aikya Chintana also, because Aikya itself has Shravana backing earlier. Tataha Jnana Dwara Mukti Rupa Phalamapi Siddhyati Eva. So there is definitely resultant mukti from this krama. Tadeva tad evam omkarasya nirguna upasanam sarva upasanebhya shreshtam. So compared to all upasanas, saguna upasanas, this nirguna upasana with omkara as an aid is shreshta compared to all sorts of upasanas across karma kanda and jnana kanda. That is why this ahangra upasana is prescribed for one who does not get the jnana during shravana, for whom manana is not possible because shravana has not fructified. For him, this upasana is prescribed because one need not go back and do everything that one has not done earlier. One can continue to do that, but hold on to this upasana with the regular karmas. And if a person is a sannyasi, and here specifically this upasana is prescribed for a sannyasi. Why? And this is another reason. For others, there are, you know, for others in the sense, one who is not a sannyasi, who has not understood what has been taught in Shravana, during Shravana, what is being taught, that one doesn't get. That person has options open for Chitta Shuddhi, many options. The Varnashrama Dharma, if one has been lagging, one should catch them up. And upasanas which one has not done, one can do. But a sannyasi has no options. He has given up his Yajnopavita, he has given up his karma. What should he do for Chitta Shuddhi? Upasana is prescribed, and that is why this Omkara Upasana Adhikara is there only for a sannyasi. Others have, you know, they can do karmas which are meant for Chitta Shuddhi. Dhyana is not really meant for Chitta Shuddhi, it is meant for Ekagrata. Sannyasi does not have those karmas at all. So sannyasi has an adhikara in prana upasana. Others have adhikara in karma and other upasanas. Anyway, so we'll stop here. We'll continue in the next part from 307. सुकन्यत्यव सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर दृप्यत्तनिव पारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परम तदेव अहन्नमत्तोन्यति मे निश्चिता मतिः तत्सत् होपफुली नो क्वेश्चंस सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट हरि ओम
नमस्कार